thanks for coming to Musa, and on behalf of Dave, John, in the kitchen, welcome. So Tim, who's standing beside me, when he won Masterchef 2011, the final was watched by 7 million people. He cooked in five countries to over 500 people, but I'm sure tonight's event's going to be the most exciting thing he's ever done since he took up cooking. So he's designed a menu, but he's also got a huge passion for beer, which we share at Musa as well. So he's handpicked some of his favourite beers to go with the dishes he's designed tonight. So it's a huge honour to have Tim Anderson up in Aberdeen. So welcome, Tim.
Hi, everybody. First of all, thanks a lot to James for having me up to cook here, and also to brew. I brewed a pretty kick-ass beer yesterday, which will be ready in about a month. And thanks to Dave and John and the kitchen team for letting me in and letting me wreak havoc in their kitchen, and also for working really hard on this dinner. There's going to be not fine dining and not quite junk food somewhere in between tonight, a bit of the ridiculous, a bit of the sublime. We're going to start you off with an amuse-bouche of haggis, neeps, and tatties. Oh yeah, and there's beer. It's 5 a.m. Saint. It's from Brewdog, and it's really going to pull out the shiitake mushroom flavor of the oat cake nicely, so pay attention to that.
It was a lot more relaxing for us because it's not the pressure of it's your food, but we cooked for Tim for the best part of the week. And we had a trial run on Monday evening, and that helped us a lot. Great to get a buzz about the place, and to have guest chefs in is always good for us to learn as well. He's just getting into working in a special kitchen, so he's getting all the bits and pieces on how a service goes through, because it's a lot different cooking in a commercial kitchen than a domestic set.
Well, I wanted to incorporate Brewdog beers. I wanted to incorporate good Scottish produce. I wanted to play around with some Scottish flavors, and I wanted to combine sort of what might be considered low-end dining with fine dining. So the bar stack scallops is one of my signature dishes. I think that it sort of makes pork scratchings just a bit more elegant. Because we all like them, and they have good flavors, so why not go with them?
If you followed the series MasterChef, I attempted an impromptu Scottish surf and turf at the Highland Games, which was venison with a side of fish pie that we used when we ran out of neeps and tatties. But this is a lot better. This is going to be a sirloin steak with some lovely lobster mash, an asparagus and hazelnut succotash, and a sauce made out of Marmite, black garlic, and whiskey, and a little bit of Riptide, actually. The beer to go with it is from Oregon. It's sort of an American classic brown ale. It's called Rogue Hazelnut Brown. It's actually got hazelnuts in it. It's a beautifully sort of off-dry brown ale. It's got some sweetness to it and a really full, nutty character that'll tie the whole dish together. It goes great with the lobster, great with the beef, great with the sauce, great with the veg. It's like a symphony.
Fantastic to have someone of Tim's stature come up to Musa and cook with us. It just kind of shows what we're about at Musa. We're about putting together exciting, innovative, contemporary, cutting-edge dishes and getting people really excited about good beer and food combinations. And to have Tim come up and put his stamp on it and kind of create some dishes and pair them with some beers just typifies what we're about at Musa. And it was a huge honour for us to host him, and we'll hopefully see him up and again in the northeast of Scotland before too much longer.
Oh yeah, no, it's been a huge change. Well, you know what they say, it's going to change your life. It's just been completely different. There's no routine, it's just jumping into little projects and projects. It's a lot of fun.
Anyway, we've come to the final course. So before I introduce it, I'd just like to thank you all for coming. Thank James for having me. thank Dave and John in the kitchen, the whole kitchen staff, for letting me in there. It's been great fun. And then John, Jones from Yatai as well, for making his amazing dish. It's been a really fun evening, so thank you very much. The last course is pineapple upside down cake, and that's pine slash apple upside down cake. It's an apple sponge and a sweet potato chantilly infused with pine, a few berries, pine nuts, and a hardcore IPA syrup. It's got a lot of sort of foresty fruit sweetness and a little bit of pine bitterness to sort of tie it all together. It's reminds me of Christmas, this course. Hope you enjoy it.
Great night. I think everybody really enjoyed it. They got the experience, some of Tim's talents from MasterChef. I think it was really successful.
Yeah, it went really well. Dave and John and the team, they were a lot of fun to work with. Kept the pressure off me for the most part, which was good, but it was a lot of fun. I'm glad people enjoyed it.